We talked a bit about thyroid before. Remember, thyroid regulates your metabolism. And if your levels are low, you're going to have a slower metabolism. You can't burn calories for energy as quickly. So what I find with a lot of patients, they've been tested by their doctor, not extensively, but they've had some thyroid tests, and their doctor tells them, your thyroid hormones are in the normal range. Well, unfortunately, when you look at reference range with lab tests, they tend to be quite wide. Matter of fact, unless you're almost dead, you tend to fall right in the reference range. You don't want to be just in the range. You want to be at least mid-range, if not the upper range of normal, right? You want optimum. You don't just want to be alive. You want to be optimal. So that's what I do with patients. If the thyroid levels are on the low side of normal, we've got to get those thyroid levels up. How do we do that? Well, you can use natural substances. For example, iodine. You know, some people have iodine deficiency because they avoid table salt. And table salt is the main source of iodine in the American diet. And they're avoiding table salt because of blood pressure issues, and that makes sense. But if you have iodine deficiency, your thyroid can't make those thyroid hormones effectively. As well, you need the mineral selenium. And selenium has been depleted from the soil in America to a large extent. So if you're not taking multivitamins, for example, you could be deficient in selenium, and you can't make those thyroid hormones effectively. The other thing I see with a lot of patients, their doctor tests their thyroid, and they do what's called a TSH, thyroid-stimulating hormone. That's the hormone which comes from your brain, actually your pituitary gland, and it stimulates your thyroid gland to produce more thyroid hormones. And it's a very generalized marker. It's like me telling you, go to the grocery store and get some vegetables. I mean, it doesn't tell you what kind, right? There's many to choose from. They may also measure what's called your T4 level, one of the main thyroid hormone levels in your body. But here's the interesting part. The main function of T4 in the human body is to be converted into the more active free T3. A lot of people have low T3 levels. Why? Well, it could be due to genetics. It can be due to insulin resistance. If you're pre-diabetic or diabetic, you have more trouble converting that T4 into the more active T3. Stress, like high levels of the stress hormone cortisol, interfere with that process. If you're deficient in certain nutrients, like the selenium I talked about, you could have low free T3 levels. That's why I even see patients who are on thyroid medicine, you know, the conventional thyroid medicines, which by the way are T4, and they just still have symptoms. They're gaining weight, they're cold, they have low energy, they have poor mood, and it's because their T3 levels are low. And so what we can do with these people is get them on the nutrients so their T3 levels get up, or get them on a natural thyroid hormone prescription, which gives them that active T3 along with the T4. Doesn't that make more rational sense? Yeah. That helps a lot of people.